Lord chosen for himself as high priest, and opening his treasure house, made him rich in all good things. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
that to you, my brothers and sisters,
that I have been
in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done
and in what I have failed to do,
through my fault,
through my most grievous fault.
Therefore,
I ask the Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and loving God, who chose blessed St. Paul VI to preside over your people and benefit them by word and example, keep safe, we pray, by his intercession, the shepherds of your church, the long-run flocks entrusted to their care, and direct them in the way of eternal salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. King Agrippa and Bernice arrived in Caesarea on a visit to Festus. Since they spent several days there, Festus referred Paul's case to the king, saying, "There is a man here left in custody by Felix. When I was in Jerusalem, the chief priests and the elders of the Jews brought charges against him and demanded his condemnation. I answered them that it was not their common practice to hand over an accused person before he has faced his accusers and had the opportunity to defend himself against the charge. So when they came together here, I made no delay. The next day, I took my seat in the tribunal and ordered the man to be brought in. His accusers stood around him, but did not charge him with any crimes I suspected. Instead, they had some issues with him about their own religion and about a certain Jesus who had died, but who Paul claimed was alive. Since I was at a loss how to investigate this controversy, I asked if you were willing to go to Jerusalem and there stand trial on his charges. And when Paul appealed that he be held in custody for the emperor's decision, I ordered him held until I could send him to Caesar." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord has established his throne.
The Lord has established his throne.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
And the Lord has established his throne.
For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he put our transgressions from us.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven and his kingdom.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, O his angels, you mighty in strength, who do his bidding.
The Lord has established his throne in heaven.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
After Jesus had revealed himself to his disciples, eating breakfast with them, he said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." He then said to Simon Peter a second time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Simon Peter answered him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, Tend my sheep. He said to him the third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was distressed that he had said to him the third time, Do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, Feed my sheep. Amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. He said this signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. And when he had said this, he said to them, Follow me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Especially the immorality of artificial birth control, which he affirmed very strongly in his encyclical Humanae Vitae, but for which he was not criticized in many quarters of the church. And secondly, for his presiding over the reform of the liturgy, which of course happened while he was pope as well, and for which he has been unfairly criticized in many circles of the church. And of course, we know that Paul, as a man of faith, did his best to follow the will of the Holy Spirit, to do what he believed was the will of God. And this took a great deal of courage, because especially when he reaffirmed his teachings of Humanae Vitae, he faced a great deal of criticism for that. And it came at great personal cost. He himself suffered very much over the response to that encyclical that came throughout the world. And yet, he held the course, he kept the faith, and he handed on the traditional teachings of the church, which is, of course, what the office of the papacy is to do. May we continue to implore the prayers of St. Paul VI, especially for those who we know are facing perhaps a lack of courage in any area of their lives, that by his intercession and by his prayers, we too may be courageous to stand up for what we believe, what the church teaches, to stand up for Jesus Christ, and always witness to our faith in him, no matter what the cost.
Pray, brothers and sisters, for my sacrifice of worship, that it be acceptable to God the Almighty.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands, for the praise of your Lord is named, for our good and the all this holy church.
Accept the sacrifice of your people, we pray, the Lord, and make what is offered for your glory, in honor of the blessed St. Paul VI, a means to our eternal salvation. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended, not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident to follow him, for he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with passing of joy, every land, your people exalt in your praise, and even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the end and end of your glory as they come. Holy, 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 God of us. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created are only gives you praise. And for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to you. Therefore, O Lord, they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself was praised. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given out. Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. Save us, save your people. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our brother, and Peter, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, inhabits your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world of all lives. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
the Good Shepherd has laid down his life for his sheep.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. May the sacrament of